Now we've covered how to UV unwrap, cube, and a cylinder, our two most fundamental unwraps to learn, I'm going to be covering a third option for UV unwrapping a cube. This is a great option for using with seamless square textures, such as this brick texture or this wood texture from CG Bootcase. To get started, we will need a cube. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube. Then I'm going to come up to the top left-hand corner, and when this cross appears, I'm just going to left-click and drag. Then I'm going to left-click my editor type here, which is this button in the top left-hand corner, and change it to UV Editor. And now you can see my 3D viewport has been changed into this UV workspace. And when I press Tab to go into Edit mode in my 3D viewport here, we can see we've got our default cross UV. First though, let's apply our texture. I'm just going to left click and drag this here, and I'm going to press Tab to go back into object mode. You can see we've got this option here, which will allow us to see any shader changes we make. Then I'm going to left click and drag this back across, just to keep things nice. I'm going to change my clock here, or timeline, to the shader editor, and then I'm just going to press plus new to add a new material. Then I'm going to press Shift A, and then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture. I'm then going to press open, and I'm going to come to my textures folder on my computer, where I've downloaded this brick textures from CG Bootcase. I'll leave the link in the description. All you'll need to do once you download it is right click the zip file and press extract all. Then in that folder, you will have all your textures. For now, I'm going to left click this base color here and just press open image. Then I'm going to press Shift A, and then under input, I'm going to choose texture coordinate. This allows us to choose how our image is mapped onto our cube. The default is UV, so we technically didn't need to add this, but I think it's good practice to improve your understanding of how input coordinates are working here. So I'm going to plug my UV into the vector, then color into the base color. Now, essentially what's happening here is if I press Tab to go into edit mode, you can see our square is being placed here, and our cross here is deciding where the texture will appear on our object. But this texture here is seamless, which means it can be repeated over and over again. For that reason, we want to have each face cover the entire surface of the texture. To do that, it's very simple. I'm going to press A in edit mode here to select all my faces, U, and then I'm going to choose, instead of smart UV project, I'm going to choose a cube projection. Now you can see, if I press 3 on the keyboard and select all my faces, you can see each face is taking up the entire size of this square. And now we've got nice repeating texture all across. Of course, if you want to change the size of this, I can press A to select everything, then come to my UV editor here and press A to select everything, and press S, and I can change the scale maybe to like 0.5 by pressing 0.5 to half it. And now you can see the bricks are a little bit bigger. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that, because maybe you don't want to alter the scale and then try and remember how to change it back later. So instead, we can come down to our nodes here, and I can press Shift A, then under Vector, I can choose Mapping, plug this in between here, and where it says Scale here, I can just left click and drag these values down and do the same thing by typing in 0.5 for half. Now we've got the exact same result, but we haven't had to change anything in our UV editor. So this makes it much easier to control. You can of course make it bigger too by changing the scale to something like 2. And if you wanted our brick texture to look like this, but have it as its own bake texture, you could bake this as well. Do keep in mind though, as you scale up an image, you will be losing some detail. But that is the nature of using image textures rather than mathematically generated nodes. And yeah, that's it. Pretty quick video today, but an important one nonetheless. If you want to catch up on the other types of UV unwraps we've been learning, make sure to check out the playlist here. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.